Thanks, everyone. Back in the 1930s, there was a baseball player named Lou Gehrig, a legendary player who played for the New York Yankees. People called him the Iron Horse. He played 2,130 consecutive games, a record that stood for 56 years. During the 1938 season, Gehrig started to feel unwell. He needed to squeeze the bat harder and was stumbling out in the field. He pulled himself out and went to the clinic where he was diagnosed with a type of motor neuron disease. This disease forced him to retire at age 36 and took his life 2 years later. The greatest baseball player of all time, a healthy, athletic adult at the prime of his career, rendered wheelchair-bound and respiratory-dependent in a matter of months. This disease is named Lou Gehrig disease, motor neuron disease, or amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, ALS. What is a motor neuron disease? It affects the nerves that are connected to the muscles, giving them commands and allowing us to move, speak, eat, and breathe. 5,000 people are living with motor neuron disease in the UK at any one time. There is one in 400 of us who will get ALS. Globally, cases are set to substantially increase, attributed mainly to an aging population. Wouldn't it be great to have treatment for ALS? To this day, riluzole is the widely used drug for ALS treatment, but it only prolongs patients' life by a few months. It got FDA approval in 1995. And up until then, neurons were thought to be the main cells affected by the disease. But studying the disease in mice helped us to understand that there are neighboring cells that contribute to the disease. These neighboring cells are called astrocytes. They are star-shaped cells that constitute a third of all cell types in the human brain. The reason why they were previously neglected because they were thought to merely be the glue of the nervous system. However, in recent times, astrocytes are gaining more attention in the scientific community due to their critical role in the central nervous system. For instance, for neurons to fire their commands to the muscles they are connected to, they need support from astrocytes in the form of nutrients, maintaining their microenvironment and orchestrating their communication. The lack of astrocyte support is one of the key factors in the progression of various neurological diseases, and it can even contribute to the death of neurons by releasing toxic substances and causing inflammation. Animal models definitely help to deepen our understanding about the disease, but unfortunately, it has not led to the much-needed new treatments for human disease. One of the most distinguishing features of the adult human brain is the complexity and diversity of its astrocytes. Astrocytes in one of the brain regions, astrocytes is 3 times bigger and has tenfold more processes than those of mouse astrocytes, which might explain why we need to study this disease in human cells. But how might this be possible? In 2006, a Japanese stem cell researcher, Chinya Yamanaka, published groundbreaking research showing that adult cells can be transformed back into a much earlier version of themselves. The so-called induced pluripotent stem cells can become any cell in the human body. In 2012, Chinya Yamanaka won the Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine. And since Yamanaka's discovery, we've been able to take skin cells from patients and reprogram them back into stem cells. We change the chemicals in the liquids that we use to guide them to become the cell of interest. I'm Doaa, final year PhD student at the Francis Crick Institute and University College London. In the lab, we model ALS. We use stem cells from patients and healthy donors to make neurons and astrocytes. We found that astrocytes are affected early on in the disease, and display changes to alter its normal functions. We can grow astrocytes together with neurons and study the communication between these cells. We found that astrocytes from patients fail to promote the survival of neurons similar compared to their healthy counterparts. We believe this results from loss of their supportive function in ALS, in addition to gaining of some sort of toxicity that makes them harmful to neighboring neurons. The human stem cell approach that I have described has allowed for efficient testing for hundreds of compounds to find suitable drugs for ultimate patient benefit. Studying human stem cells-derived astrocytes in neurons has provided us with unprecedented opportunity to understand more about how the disease starts and develops, and therefore identify new targets for potential treatments. I've been studying astrocytes during the 4 years of my PhD, and I'm amazed by their critical role in supporting neurons. And it reminds me that we need to keep on supporting patients, and we need to keep on trying to find cure for motor neuron disease, so patients wouldn't have to endure what Louis Garrick and countless others went through. Last Sunday, I woke up to great news that filled me with hope. The United to End Motor Neuron Disease campaign has successfully secured a government investment of £50 million. Thanks to the efforts from patients, like the former rugby player Dodie Weir, and the support from carers, scientists, clinicians, and researchers, and Motor Neuron Disease Association. I'm hoping in the next few years we'll be able to cure motor neuron disease and maybe harnessing the potentials of the neglected stars in supporting neurons would take us closer to our goal. Thank you.